Remote calls are fundamental in networking your game. Remote calls are used to communicate between the same script on the client on the same object to the same script and object on the server, as well vice versa, going from the server to client. Remote calls have a vast amount of uses. Some common ones are moving a player, firing a weapon, or showing change in your environment such as a door opening. There are three remote calls: server RPC, observer's RPC, and target RPC. To demonstrate remote calls, I'll be changing colors on a sprite. After introducing what each remote call does, I'll also demonstrate them. Starting off will be server RPC. A server RPC will allow you to send data from a client to the server. A client firing their weapon is a very common use of a server RPC. A server RPC method must have the server RPC attribute above it. There is optionally the require ownership field, which is by default true. Should you not specify values for any of the optional fields, they will use their default values, such as if I were to remove require ownership, it would default to true. When require ownership is true, the client calling the server RPC must have ownership of the object for the RPC to go through. For more information on ownership, check out the ownership video. When require ownership is false, clients may send a server RPC to the object without being the owner. You may find this useful for buttons or doors in your world. No particular client may own that button or door, but all clients will likely need to interact with it. Observer's RPC is next and is used to send data from the server to all observing clients. Ideally, whichever data is sent should be known to all clients, such as perhaps a player's name. To specify an observer's RPC, you must place the observer's RPC attribute above the method name. There are two optional fields, buffer last and include owner. Buffer last by default is false, but could be extremely useful as true. When buffer last is true, the last values to be sent through this remote call will also be sent to new observers or clients. Perhaps you updated an important state of the object through an observer RPC, like the object's model. To ensure even clients joining later see the correct model, you can set buffer last to true, and those late joining clients will also receive remote call with the latest values. Include owner is as described and defaults to true. While true, the owner of the object will also get the RPC. While false, all observers except the owner will get the RPC. Target RPC's function is to send a remote call to a single connection. You would use target RPCs for data you want only a specific client to know about. An example would be sending a target RPC to the object owner containing items in their inventory. The first parameter is a network connection. This is the client the target RPC will send to. All target RPCs must have the first parameter as network connection. And like server and observer's RPC, a target RPC must also have the target RPC attribute above it. Going up a little, you will notice where I call target set color, I am passing in the owner of the object as the first argument. The owner is a network connection type. This means a target RPC is going to the owner of this object. In the same coroutine, I have a very simple check on if I should be calling server, observers, or target RPC. Please notice that this coroutine simply calls the RPCs, and the RPCs themselves is what changes the color. In the editor, I have a player prefab with the remote call script we just looked through. To begin, I'm going to add remote call type on server RPC, and then make a build and start the editor. The editor is running as server and the build as client. You can see in the editor that gut server RPC is printing, and the color is updating on the server. The color is not updating on the client because the colors only update in the RPCs, and since I'm calling a server RPC, it's only going to happen on the server and not client. Back in the editor, I set the remote call type to observers. I'm going to make a new build, but this time set the build as server and editor as client. Now, the server is not updating colors, but the client is. This is because the RPC is going to clients. Just as if I were to connect another client, you will see the colors align on both clients, since this is an observer's RPC, meaning it goes to all clients. This is a great opportunity to demonstrate the buffer last field as well. In the code, I have it set to the default of false. Notice when I connect the second client, it sees the first player's color as white. Let's do this a couple times so that you can see it happening. The color only updates after a new observer's RPC comes through. Back in the code real quick, I set buffer last to true. And now let's get builds open again. With buffer last as true, when I bring in the second client in and out of the game, they immediately receive the last values sent through the RPC. The last demonstration is using target RPC. For this, I'm going to set the remote call type to disabled on the prefab, and again open two builds in the editor. After starting the server and a single client, I'm going to select the player object in the server and set the remote call type to target RPC. demonstrated in the code, this will only send a remote call to the owner of the object. When looking at the client, we can see they are getting the latest value because they are in fact the owner, but watch what happens when I bring in another client. The second client does not see the color changes because they are only going to the owner using the target RPC.